Hello students, let us start with a new topic today in SOM. The name of the chapter is Torsion. When we say torsion, the meaning of torsion is twisting or torsional moment. So whenever we talk about torsion, it is such that we have a twisting, or you can say torsional moment. This can be explained with a diagram. Here we have a diagram in which there is a shaft. And bearing. Shaft is that member which rotates. So if we are rotating the shaft and it is supported inside a bearing, if a shaft rotates in clockwise direction, bearing will try to oppose its motion in the opposite direction. So here at the shaft we are having clockwise rotation, at the bearing end we are having anti-clockwise rotation. Because of these two unequal torques, there is twisting of this shaft. This example is like if I have this pin, if I am rotating the pin in two opposite directions at the each of the ends, if I rotate it in the opposite direction, then this pin would be twisting, and that twisting is nothing but torsion. Now when we say torsion, torsion can also be called as torque, and torque is the product of tangential force Ft multiplied by the radius of the shaft. Because of the product of Ft into R, this shaft would be rotating. So I can say that torque T is equal to tangential force into radius of the shaft. The unit is, tangential force would be in Newton, radius would be in mm. So here I have the torque in terms of Newton mm. So in other words, whenever we talk about torsion, the simplest way to understand torsion is that it is twisting, and twisting is produced by two unequal moments, one which would be in clockwise direction and the other in anti-clockwise direction. Simply we can give torque as tangential force into the radius of the shaft, that is, this product gives a rotation and it would be in the direction of Ft. So here I have clockwise rotation. So this was a brief concept regarding torsion. Now let me give you the torsional equation. The torsional equation is given by T by J is equal to Fs by R is equal to G theta by L. Here I will be defining all the terms. Capital T, it is the torque or twisting moment. Unit will be in Newton mm. J is called as polar moment of inertia. Unit will be in mm raised to 4. Fs would be called as shear stress. Unit will be Newton per mm square. Capital R will be the radius of shaft. G means modulus of rigidity. Unit will be Newton per mm square. Theta is angle of twist. Unit will be radians. and capital L, it indicates the length of shaft. Which will be in terms of mm. So this is the torsional equation which we have, and here I have defined all the terms. Now this angle of twist, it can be explained in such a way that if we have this diagram of a shaft, I consider point A on the shaft, and when the twisting occurs, this point A will be shifted to another location called as A dash, and from the center of the shaft, if I consider this, here I have a small angle, and this small angle would be called as theta, that is the angle of twist, and this angle of twist would be there all along the length of the shaft. So here I have theta, which is the angle of twist, which would be constant along the length. So this is angle of twist theta. Next, let me give you all two equations to solve the problems on torsion. The first equation would be called as based on strength criteria. So based on strength criteria, we have the torsional equation as T by J is equal to Fs by R. This is called as strength criteria because here we have shear stress. Next, based on rigidity criteria, I have the formula. T by J is equal to G theta by L. This is called as rigidity criteria because here I have modulus of rigidity G and angle of twist theta. So based on these two criteria, we can solve any problem related to shafts.